a left-leaning group called Demand Justice, which was founded in 2018 by former Obama staffers, is running a campaign right now. They've started a petition, and they also have ads running out there, billboards and whatnot, begging Supreme Court Justice Stephen Breyer to retire because they want Joe Biden to be able to replace him on the Supreme Court, as opposed to perhaps 4 years from now, a Republican replacing Justice Breyer, right? And Democrats, left-leaning groups, liberals, progressive, whatever you want to call them, they do have a reason, a valid reason for fear. Obviously, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, still very fresh on everyone's memory. She was a phenomenal Supreme Court justice, passed away in office, gets replaced by Amy Barrett, right? You could not have picked a more polar opposite human being from RBG than Coney Barrett. That's a horrible, horrible replacement. And Democrats don't want to see that same thing happen again. They know Justice Breyer's been there for a very long time. Guy's very, let's say, up there in age. And who knows, right? Nobody can predict what will or will not happen. And so they're saying, listen, everything is unpredictable. So why don't you step down? And of course, their actual demand is for Joe Biden to replace him with the first African-American woman on the U.S. Supreme Court. I have no problem with that at all. I think their whole tactic, though, is a little misguided. Because I don't think Justice Breyer is the person that they need to be lobbying. They need to be lobbying Joe Biden. They need to be lobbying the Democrats in the Senate to demand that they do something about it. You know, Biden signed the executive order late last week saying he was going to form a commission to look into possibly expanding the Supreme Court, right? A meaningless gesture, to be honest with you, because he could have just signed and said, hey, all right, I'm gonna demand we do this. All right, Democrats in the Senate, let's get on this. Let's pass it. Let's make it happen. Of course, that wouldn't have done anything either. But commission just makes it seem like, okay, I'm going to placate you. I've got the commission. We're going to do some things. Okay, so just shut up. He needs to do more. A commission is certainly not good enough. It's a decent enough start, I guess, maybe. But does it actually accomplish anything? No. He knows that we need to expand the Supreme Court. I mean, you don't need a commission to tell you that. You don't need to run studies on that. We have a hard right U.S. Supreme Court with a 6-3 majority, and we could change that. Simple as that, right? It really, truly is as simple as that. Now, expanding it obviously is a little bit harder, but coming to the determination that we need to expand it, obviously, that's a no-brainer. The other thing that I don't like about this is we shouldn't have to beg anybody to retire. We really shouldn't. I mean, honest to God, the Supreme Court has just become a game. It's become a game between the Democrats and Republicans. You know, oh, who can pack it more? Oh, we can get these people, but we got these people. Oh, now we're in charge. Now we're in charge. The whole thing is stupid, but it was set up stupidly at the beginning of the country, right? This is written into the Constitution. These people are appointed for life. So we either have to wait for scandal or death or retirement. Those are the only three things that can get rid of a United States Supreme Court justice. And guess which one is the most popular? Yeah, that sucks. These people should not be serving lifetime appointments. No judge in this country should. I mean, does everybody understand? We still have judges serving on the bench in this country that were appointed by Jimmy Carter. Yeah. Yeah, there's judges from the Carter era still hearing cases today from the 70s. This is nuts. It's truly nuts. Put some friggin' term limits on there. But in order to do that, of course, that is a Herculean effort of actually changing the United States Constitution. It's not impossible, but it is absolutely one of the hardest things that we could do. And to be honest, it's really the only choice we have to get a Supreme Court that actually functions properly.